all, keep it all, trash it all, leave it just like sheep it all, hate it all, love it all, and still you'd have nothing.
I picked a rose this morning, and it was so fresh. It looked like it was crying. I thought how sad to be so beautiful, only to wither and die. Like Barbara's roses, soft and pale, like petals thrown in the dirt. Only silence is spoken here, all that grows here is hurt. And Papa's roses.
He took off east one morning in the rising sun's red glow. She knew he was going nowhere, but of course she let him go. As she stood and watched him dwindle, much too empty to be sad, he reappeared beside her and said, "You're all I've ever had." Shooting star, she was softer and more slowly. He could not make things possible, but she could make them holy. Oh, he was the sun, burning bright and brittle, and she was the moon, shining back his light a little. He was a shooting star, she was softer and more slowly. He could not make things possible, but she could make them holy. Holy.
So I often think of you. Every time I hold my baby in my arms, I say a prayer for
We've only just begun to live. White lace and promises, a kiss for luck and we're on our way. Before the rising sun, we fly. We started walking and learning to ride. This would just be done. Sharing horizons that are new to us.
Why is Pat Benatar singing We've Only Just Begun?
She didn't know Evergreen and this was Wendy's second choice.
Your hair is glowing. person. Peter Baines over here.
It's from his first marriage.
We don't talk about that one. Oh, jeez. Oh, speaking of marriage. Thanks for coming into our living room here today. Okay, next song has a little story. It goes like this. This is the day in the life of us. It's been the same for the last 31 years. I get up about 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, drink about a dozen cups of green tea, run about 105,000 miles. Patricia wakes up about 8 o'clock in the morning. She comes into the kitchen. I say, "Hey, baby, how you feeling this morning?" She goes,
"Hi, Spider. How are you today?"
That's our usual day, I promise.
Maybe not quite like that.
Yeah, sort of like that. And then, one day, and that's how it usually is, one day, 8 o'clock in the morning comes along, I'm in a great mood, we had a great night, it was fantastic. She walks into the kitchen, I say, "Hey baby, how you doing today? You looking good." She says, "Don't talk to me, you're stupid." I hate you so much. So, once again, I'm in a slight dilemma because I really thought I knew something about women. I have 2 dogs and they're female. I have a housekeeper, she's female. I got 2 daughters and obviously they're female. So I got all these women around. I thought I really knew something about women. And once again, I prove I'm 100% wrong. I'm convinced that they come from another creator. It's not the same. And I'd never be able to figure out how they think. So I just gave that up. So I just waited until she decided to explain why she was in such a bad mood. And it goes like this. She had a dream, and in her dream, I was with another woman.
See, this happened to them.
I'm here to tell you, because I know I got some Sicilian cousins and brothers out there, sisters. My Italian DNA has me hardwired to never cheat on my woman.
That's right.
Ever. Yeah. With that in mind, Patricia knows that I like to write songs first thing in the morning, so she says, "I'll tell you what, I wrote the dream down, and I wrote these lyrics, and I'm going to give them to you, and if you write a song by 6 o'clock in the evening, I may like you better." So I took the words, and I turned them into a song. 6 o'clock in the evening came, she still didn't like me any better. So now your job is just to listen to the lyrics, because they're really great. So it's called, "I Don't Want to Be Your Friend, I Just Want to Be Your Lover."